afternoon, it struck me that nothing could provide a more appropriate setting for remembering a scholar, a teacher, and a colleague who dedicated his career to the life of this campus and wanted nothing more than to see this campus come to life. For Kenneth Lindsay, as we've already heard, was the very embodiment of that spirit of service and belief in public education that built this institution from the field in which we would be sitting today, but for the unstoppable commitment of Ken and his colleagues in that pioneering generation.
Lectures on art and music in different historical periods. Ken was a talented cellist and knew a lot of music history. He was a superb teacher and a mentor to a number of talented students who many years later, as professors or museum directors, spoke highly of his influence on their career. One of these candidates was Clifford Brown, who was also a student in one of my music history classes in the 1950s. Ken and I were working on a project that questioned the use of the term impressionism to describe the music of Davidson. At one point, we got into a discussion with Clifford on the subject. He politely but firmly disagreed with our thesis and effectively stood his ground. I wasn't surprised a few years later to learn that he'd become an art history professor. He was probably the first of the many students over the years so effectively mentored by Professor Lindsay.
All the memories that Ken Lindsay has shared with me over the years, easily among those of which he was most fond, is the one that relates to his first professional paper, given at the annual meeting of the College Art Association held in Washington during the last days of January 1951. At the time, he was teaching at Williams College, serving in the art history department as a one-year replacement, and just a few months later, he would travel to Binghamton to set up the art history program here. One of his colleagues, the distinguished medievalist Witt Stoddard, liked what he had heard of Lindsay's lectures and pulled some strings to get him onto the modern art panel at that year's CAA gathering. Lindsay's presentation, culled from a chapter of the dissertation yet not quite completed on Kandinsky, went well enough. But the real reward came at the end of the session. As he was walking out of the hall, he overheard one senior scholar say to another, "You know, that talk on Kandinsky is going to totally revolutionize our approach to his argument."